One night, at the engine sheds, Donald was very excited. "You know," he said to the other engines, "the diesels at the works say that on the other railway there are things called high-speed trains. They have a diesel at each end and can reach speeds over 100 miles per hour." "Bah," grumbled Gordon. "An engine at each end? There's only one of me, but I bet I could go as fast as those smelly diesels, and probably even faster." The other engines didn't take much notice. They knew Gordon well, and had dealt with his boasting before. Gordon was still grumbling the next morning. "I'll show them! I'll show them!" If he had been more concentrated, he would have noticed the frost that had settled outside the station tracks that night. "Get in quickly, please," boomed Gordon. So the people got in quickly, and the guard blew his whistle and waved his green flag. The driver slowly opened the regulator. That had done it. Gordon jerked forward, sloshing water over the regulator valve, jamming it completely. Gordon's wheels spun fiercely again and again, as the heavy weight of the coaches held him back. The driver tried every trick he knew, but it was no good. The regulator was stuck fast. The fat controller, disturbed by the noise, came out of his office to see what the fuss was about. Himself, along with the driver and fireman, tried even more tricks to unjam the regulator. At last, even the fat controller gave up. "I'm afraid," he said to the driver, "that you'll have to wait until he runs out of steam." Gordon kept slipping again and again for over an hour. His rods and his wheels ached, but there was nothing he could do. At last, battered, weary and beaten, Gordon ran out of steam and came to a complete stop. The silence across the station was amazing. Later that day, Donald came along with the breakdown train to help sort out the mess. Gordon stayed silent for the rest of the evening. He had a lot to think about high-speed trains.